Professor Hallux's Eye Guide with the Association of British Dispensing Opticians.
I'm over here.
Of course you are.
No, here.
I say, Nurse Nanobot, you've really lost weight.
That's a broom, Professor Hallux. Honestly, you really need to have your eyes tested. Come on, let's pay a visit to Sally Specs. She's a dynamic dispensing optician.
What a great idea. We can get some eye-opening facts for my eye guide too.
Hello there, Professor. It's been a while since we last saw you. Let's check. Well, I didn't think it had been that long since you last came in. You need to get your eyes tested more regularly, at least every 2 years, not 10. Right, first off, let's get you in to see Simon Squint. He's our brilliant optometrist who'll examine and test your eyes.
So, tell me, Mr. Squint, can you see what it is?
Yep, hold still. It's definitely an eyeball. Most people have two eyes, each the size of a ping pong ball.
But don't ever attempt to take your eyeballs out for a game, because the eye is made of a muscle fibre, tissue and intraocular fluid, so it is more likely to go splat than boing.
Good heavens, no, really don't go around poking your eyes. They're very delicate.
Well, why don't you tell us more about it? It all sounds eye-poppingly interesting.
Well, right at the front, here, you've got your eyelid. It keeps the eye clean and moist by opening and shutting several times a minute when you blink. The great thing about blinking is that you can blink whenever you want, but blinking is also involuntary, which means your body does it without you even thinking about it. Fluid comes from tiny holes in your eyelid called tear ducts. They wash away the dirt and germs and keep things nice and moist.
So, there's more to tears than having a good cry.
That's right. Your eyelids also have great reflexes, which means they will shut automatically when there's something close to the eye, which might harm the eyeball, or when the light is just too bright.
Shutters down? So what about eyelashes? What's the point of them?
Eyelashes work with the eyelids to keep dirt and other unwanted stuff out of your eyes. Let's take a closer look. Hold still. We're looking at the sclera. This is the white part of your eyeball, and it's like the outer coat. If you look closely at your eyes in a mirror, you can see tiny pink threads, which are the blood vessels delivering blood to the sclera.
And if you're tired or poorly, those vessels can make your eyes seem redder than normal.
Okay, take us in, Mr. Squint.
Going further in, we have the cornea. This is a transparent dome that sits in front of the coloured part of the eye. It helps the eye focus as light makes its way through.
You can hardly see it. It's like a thin glass window, letting the light in.
Eyes don't look very active, but close up you can see there are lots of muscles at work. This is the iris. You see it as the coloured part of your eye, but it's actually a ring of muscle which relaxes and tightens to allow just the right amount of light through the pupil.
That's the bit that looks like a little black dot. It's actually the gap in the centre of the iris.
Can you squeeze us through, Dr. Squint? Breathe in, everyone!
After light enters the pupil, it hits the lens. Like a microscope, the lens helps you to focus on things wherever they are, if you look at something close up or far away. The lens changes its shape to get things into focus, becoming thicker or thinner to focus the image onto the retina.
Hang on, retina? Hey, Nanobot! Wasn't she your great-aunt on your mother's side, second removed?
Don't be absurd! The retina is the area of the eye where the focused image is carried to the brain.
So, what's all this wobbly stuff in here?
Deep inside the eye is the vitreous body. This forms two-thirds of the eye's volume and gives the eye its shape. It's filled with a clear, jelly-like material called the vitreous humour.
Doesn't look very humorous to me.
Right, all that information about what's inside the eye can go into the eye guide. Let's get it uploaded.
Processing data.
Upload complete.
Oh, before you go, Professor, have you got time for a further quick fact for the eye guide?
I don't see why not.
Well, did you know that glasses are so fashionable these days that even people who don't need them will buy glasses just with plain lenses? People like Justin Bieber, Cheryl Cole, and Miley Cyrus have all been spotted wearing glasses just for fun.
That's incredible, both eye-watering and inspiring.
Professor Hallux's Eye Guide with the Association of British Dispensing Opticians.
Find out more and get hands-on at funkidslive.com/Hallux.